morning. Yeah, our story today is called Anasi the Spider. And so we're talking about spiders, and I brought with me a bunch of plastic spiders to talk about spiders for a minute before we do the story. This time of year, it's always kind of fun to talk about. You know, some people find spiders kind of creepy, but I find them really, really interesting. And so I thought I'd just show you a suggestion to do because Halloween is coming up and you might want to try this later. Just for fun, to add a little creepy Halloween spidery kind of fun. So I went out this morning and I got a stick, and I thought spider webs are some of the most interesting things. When I'm outside, or even when I'm in my house and I walk into a room that I haven't dusted in a while, I find spider webs. How do they do it? So we're going to build our own spider web here on a stick. And you can do this later if you happen to be outside. I just got some yarn and I'm twisting it around. Spiders are so good. Of course, lots of spiders do spider webs with their own silk. And they stick it to the branches or the corner of a building or wherever they can to catch the insects that they eat. And right now I am just wrapping this around the stick. The spiders are such good engineers. They have to make a spider web that's strong enough to catch and sticky enough to catch the insects that they eat. And so some spiders, of course, spin webs with their silk in circles, and some like make little baskety webs, and some just have strands of silk all over. So this is just a little fun thing that you can do, and it's kind of decorative and it's kind of Halloween-y. Just a suggestion for some fun things to do while we're thinking about spiders. Oh, and I happen to have some really fuzzy yarn, and I'm going to wrap that around too. That'll look really cool, but you can do any colors that you want and make yourself a spider web to use for Halloween. And my question is, how do spiders make a spider web and not get stuck in it themselves? Well, they have the ability to spin some strands of silk that are sticky and some that are not. So I'm going to put my spider on the web right here. And he's waiting for a bug to come along. Here's a beetle to get stuck. And then boing, 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 he can feel the vibrations of the web and he comes down and eats his prey. So there we go. So now I think we should get to the story. Anasi the spider, it comes from Africa, and it's a folk tale. And so let's get our, I got a PowerPoint with all the pictures and all the illustrations, and here we go. So yeah, Anasi the spider, a tale from the Ashanti people in Africa. And the story is by Gerald McDermott, and he put a lot of the folk tale together into this great story. Okay, here we go, Anasi the spider. Anasi, he is spider to the Ashanti people. In Ashanti land, people love the story of Anasi the spider. Time was, Anasi had 6 sons. First son was called Sea Trouble. He had the gift of seeing trouble a long way off. Second son was Road Builder. Thirsty son was River Drinker. Next son was Game Skinner. Can you see all the symbols on the illustrations of our spider sons here? That's how we can tell them apart. So next son was Game Skinner. Another son, middle one there, was Stone Thrower. And last son was Cushion. He was very soft. All were good sons of Anasi. One time, Anasi went a long way from home. See him kind of going over the landscape there. A long way from home, far from home. He got lost. Oh, and he fell into trouble. Splash. Uh-oh. That looks like a stream that he fell into. Oh, no. Back home was Son Sea Trouble. Father is in danger, he cried. He knew it quickly, and he told those other sons. Road Builder's son said, follow me. So there they go, all the other sons. Off he went, making a road. They went fast, those six brothers, to help. And they were gone to help Anase. Where's father now? Oh, there's that fish again. Where is father now? Fish has swallowed him. Anase is inside fish. Can you see him? River drinker. River drinker took a big drink. No more river. Then, Game Skimmer helped Father Anase. He split the fish open. You can see Game Skinner. Yeah. Squawk! Squawk! What's happening? More trouble came right then. It was Falcon. Took Anase up into the sky. Quick now, stone thrower. What's he doing? The stone hit Falcon. Anase fell through the sky. Now Cushion ran to help Father. Very soft, Anase came down. See him landing on Cushion. They were very happy, that spider family. There they all are. All home again that night, Anase found a thing in the forest. What is this? A great globe of light? Oh, mysterious and beautiful. Look at that. Great globe of light. I shall give this to my son, said Anase, to the son who rescued me. But which son of six deserves the prize? That beautiful globe of light. Niame, oh Niame, can you help me? Called Anase. For the Ashanti people, Niame is the god of all things. There he is. Anase asked this of Niame. Please hold this beautiful globe of light until I know which son should have it for his own. Which son should have it for his own. And so they tried to decide which son deserved the prize. They tried, but they couldn't decide, and they argued all night. Naomi saw this. The god of all things, he took the beautiful white light up into the sky. Oh, what was that light? He keeps it there for all to see. It's still there. It will always be there. And it should be there tonight. And that's the end of our story. What was that great light? Looked to me like it was the moon. Yeah. So that's a great folk tale about how the moon got into the sky from the Ashanti people in Africa. And there are lots more Anase stories. And he always seems to get into a little bit of trouble. So it's kind of like the coyote stories from the Native Americans. He always seems to get into some kind of trouble. Okay, well, that was a really great folk tale. It's one of my favorites. But I also like the artwork from the story that the book has lots of great artwork, you know, from the way the spiders look to the way the spider webs look. And so I'm going to switch. We're going to do two projects here. I'm going to switch my camera to the tabletop so that you can see what I'm doing. And I'll show you what I've got. For a painting project in a minute, I'm going to use a paper plate and a white piece of paper. But right now, I'm going to use another just piece of paper. So if you have a couple of pieces of paper with you, you can do this. And I have a crayon. So I'm going to just begin to draw a spider web because I'm kind of inspired by the artwork in the book. It had a lot of patterns and symbols. So I am making a spider web by putting a bunch of X's across my paper. And then these are like all the strands of that spider web. And then between each one of these, there's a little triangle, I could go and put a pattern of shapes in each one of these spiderweb sections. And it could take a long time because look at how many sections I have. So I'm going to start with this one. I'm going to put some zigzags across here. In every shape, I'm going to do something different. So there we go. And maybe I will do some things. And once you start doing this, kind of doodle and decide what you want in each section. Maybe like this. It turns out to be a great pattern wheel. So you can finish that later, but see how you get patterns upon patterns upon patterns. Kind of fun to do. And it'll take a long time because you've got all those sections to fill in. And I used a purple crayon so you could see it, but you can use any color that you'd like and you can switch colors. That's just a little fun project to do. But right now, the one that I'd like us to do together has some paint involved with it. So for my supplies that you have, I've got a pizza cutter or a pastry cutter, and I've got a paper plate to hold my paint. I've got a white piece of paper, or you could use a black piece of paper and use different color paints. And so then I have a toilet paper tube. I have some black paint that I'm going to squirt into my paper plate, and I've got some red paint too. So let's see what happens. We're going to try to paint a spider web. So I'm going to squirt some paint onto my paper plate like that. All right, and this is a nice dark color because I have a white sheet of paper. So if you had a black sheet of paper, you might want to use some white paint, and that would really make it look like spider webs in the dark. So now I'm taking my pastry cutter and I'm going to roll it into the paint. So what does that do? That picks up paint on my pastry cutter. And I've got it all loaded up. Can you see there's paint on my pastry cutter? So now I'm going to make from the corner, you know, because spiders have to have a place to hook their webs. So maybe they'll start in the corner of your room or the corner of your garage, and they start to hook their web. And so now I'm going to roll. Whoops. Let's see. There we go. That didn't show up there. I'm rolling paint from the corner, and I'm rolling my web. Now, it's just sort of starting out, and I keep having to put more paint on my pastry color. It's making some lines. It runs out of paint really fast. Oh, there we go. Plus, it rolls to a different section where there isn't any paint, so you have to kind of roll and roll and roll and roll and roll and roll and roll. There it goes. Oh, that's a nice long one, and another nice long one, and another nice long one. Oh, is it looking spiderwebby? I hope so. Here we go. Spiderwebby, spiderwebby. So I'm crisscrossing a little because not all spiders spin circular webs. Sometimes they do baskets. Sometimes they just do a whole lot of fuzz. Sometimes they just string out strands to catch those insects. So each time I'm getting my pizza cutter into the paint and I'm making lines all across my paper that look like spider webs. So I hope you can do this at home. Here we go. Okay, whoops. There we go. Connected. Do you think that is a strong enough spider web to catch a bug? Well, I hope so. This is looking pretty good. So crisscross, crisscross, crisscross. Spider web, spider web, spider webs. So now I think we should put a spider in this web, don't you? All right, so I set my pizza cutter aside. I'm pulling out my paper towel tube and I'm pulling out, I want a red spider. So I'm shaking up my red paint. I'm gonna put a little blob of, whoops, you can't see that. There, a little blob of red paint, hopefully, on my paper plate. Ooh, oh my goodness. That sprayed all out, sweet. And there we go, it sprayed all out. Did you hear that? Was a great noise. So now I'm taking the edge of my paper towel tube and I'm running it through that red paint because I want a red spider. And I'm gonna put my spider, let's see, up in the corner there. And he's waiting for a bug to come. So let's see. There we go. There's my spider. And I'm filling them in. I'm actually just dabbing to fill his body in. And then I'm going to take a little piece of paper towel and I'm going to wipe off the spiderweb color from my pizza cutter. Yeah, this is messy, of course. And I'm gonna roll it through the red. So I got a lot of the purple, a lot of the dark color off. It could be black or purple, or it could be white if you're doing it on black paper. And I'm gonna roll my pizza cutter into the red paint. I made the body of the spider with the paper towel tube. Now I'm getting some red paint on my pizza cutter. Gonna give that spider some legs, right? One. How many legs does a spider have? There's two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. One more. Eight. There we go. So there's my spider and there's my spider web. And so today is all about spiders. I hope you had fun or will have fun creating some of the things that we did today. And I hope you enjoyed listening to the story all about Anasi the spider. There we go. So join us again next time. Where you get to make choice. Was it a giant Tyrannosaurus Rex? Okay, so how are we gonna paint the pine cones? Maybe three pine cones. What do you think? Yeah, three pine cones. And then the fun starts. What's happening here? Well, when we pull back on our little shooter here, that creates potential energy. And then when I let it fly, it turns that potential energy into kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy of motion. And boom!